Hi there! Thank you for joining me for Yarn Bite with Nora, and boy am I excited today! If I got a story for you, this is a new project, so I'm pretty excited. I did some weaving. How about this, kids? Look at this. It's a scarf for my son. Huh? It's 100% acrylic. Of course, it has some cotton for the weft. And this is the main body. Is pinwheel acrylic. It's a variegated yarn. The main color is gold. So I used corals, I used golds, I used various shades of green, browns, blues. I just had so much fun. Like a little kid playing in a box of crayons, I got to use all the colors in the box. Here we go. And I had access to so many little bits and little tidbits of yarn, as you can see behind me, because I'm at the Lamb's Loom in McAllen, Texas, where I also happen to take lessons on the rigid heddle loom with Gail White. She's an experienced knitter, crocheter. She used to raise her own rabbits, goats, not Afghans, because that would be a dog, but not llamas, but she's amazing. Miss Gail White was my teacher. It took me about 3 days to make this, and I have joined some of the rigid heddle loom groups on Facebook, and let me tell you, ladies, just browsing through there last night, I learned so much. I learned you don't literally beat the yarn in the rows. You don't beat it with the heddle. Why don't they call it tap into place? I understand, because if I'm going to beat, I'm going to beat it to death within an inch of its life. So I noticed that you ladies, before you washed it, there were actually spaces between the rows of yarn, and mine was turning out pretty dense. I ended up making more tapestry, and near the end is where I started to relax, and you can tell that the fabric's more pliable. More like a garment shape. But thank you so much, ladies, for posting your projects. Just looking at your beautiful, beautiful projects has been an inspiration for me. And I just wanted to share this with you all. It's done. I do recommend, if you want to invest in a loom, get lessons from someone. I had a catastrophe. The lashing came untied. My warp slipped off, but because I had seen, I took part in warping my loom, after I settled down, I was able to slip them back on the back beam and retie the back lashing. So, finished it, and I'm so excited, and I recommend anybody, if you want to have some fun with colors, try weaving. It's a lot of fun. Thank you for joining me. Stop by on my page, my Facebook page, Yarn Bite with Nora. Until next time, take care. Bye-bye.